You are now about to learn everything you need to know today about the DNA paternity testing process. Hello, my name is Garth Harvey, and I'm the DNA testing specialist with the DNA Testing Center. And I just wanted to take a few moments today just to briefly explain how to collect a DNA sample for yourself when you receive a DNA paternity testing home kit. It's a quite simple process. I just wanted to take a few moments since we get asked this question a whole lot, so I wanted to address it a little bit today. And pretty much it's extremely simple. Once you receive your DNA paternity testing kit, inside of it you will have two packets that look and resemble the ones that I have in my hand, which are cotton swabs, these packets here. Inside of them, you'll have two cotton swabs inside. Now I'm just going to take a few moments, open this here. Now, as I stated inside, you have two cotton swabs. You want to take one cotton swab and proceed to swab inside of your cheek and your gum, actually between your cheek and your gum. We find, as opposed to just scraping in between or on your cheek it's alone, there's a less probability that you won't get enough genetic material when you swab in between your cheek and your gum as opposed to just your cheek. So we suggest that when you're collecting your own sample, you want to take the cotton swab and place it in between your cheek and your gum and rotate. So I'm going to show you exactly how this is done. As you notice, I kept my free hand on the outside of where I was swabbing on my cheek. And this, we find, is a little bit better. We haven't had as many issues, nowhere near as many issues at all, in terms of getting a low frequency of genetic material when we swab it that way. And then we do it for 30 seconds just to make sure. Doing it any less amount of time, it works fine. Many other institutions actually do it that way, but we at IDTO, we like to make sure that we have the highest frequency of genetic material. This way, we're not asking you to submit another DNA sample. Now, once you're done with collecting the swab on one side, you want to do the same thing on the other side. Then you're going to take each cotton swab and you're going to place it in the envelope it actually comes in. And then you'll place it in the envelope, seal the envelope, and then place it in the return shipping that you receive from our facility. There you have it. Pretty simple. If you have any other questions in regards to the DNA paternity testing process, please don't hesitate to give us a call. You can see the number right here at 877-680-5800. And subscribe to this channel. We will be producing more videos in regards to DNA paternity testing, specific situations to DNA paternity testing, scenarios. We will be discussing what are the most likely scenarios one can use a paternity test outside of the normal child custody. So we will be addressing some of those issues. But if you have anything that you would like us to talk about here at IDTO, what you can actually do is leave a comment below. And we will address any questions, concerns in regards to the DNA paternity testing process. And just so you know, we have a turnaround time. Once all of your samples are submitted, we have a turnaround time of about 2 to 3 business days from in which our laboratory receives all samples. So again, I want to thank you for taking a few moments out of your busy day to converse with us. And once again, my name is Garth Harvey. I am the DNA testing specialist with the DNA Testing Center here at IDTO. Thank you.